mahigugma nga igsoon kay Kristo bayong gabi kaninyong tanan. Salamat kaayo sa inyo padayon na pagkuyog paguban sa atong live streaming na Santos ng Eucharistia. May the peace of the Lord be with you all there as you join us and as we reflect on the good news. Mga igsoon kay Kristo, ako anay katong bago lang namatay, no? Nagpass away akong inahan. Adto ako sa isa ka grocery o siguro coping man to, no? Nagpangita lang ko sa mga chips para lang ibutang sa tiyan ba kay grabe kaayong kaguol nga ako na sinati. I feel lonely kay my mother just passed away, no? Tapos na ama to nagduol nga babae nga may edad na kag ang iyang mata ba pagduol sa ako, ha? Pagduol niya, ang iyang expression daw, naduoy dyan siya sa ako, ha? Okay, ang microphone medyo naga... hello? Okay. So mga igsoon, basit may change of quality, so hopefully ang quality sa homily mag-improve man, no? Oh. Mga igsoon, katong iyang pagduol, she was looking at me daw, naluoy kaayo, ingon niya, kaila kong imong inahan. Ako ko, ah, okay. Kauban mi sa isa ka asosasyon sa parokya. Ako ko, okay. And then, ingon niya, kaluoy ka man, no? Mabot ko, masabta na to na sa Cebuano. Nang kaluoy ka ba? And then, hilom lang ko. Tapos, ingon niya, kaluoy ka kay usa ka na lang. Orphan ka na. Sa mind ko, hilom lang ko. Pero sa mind ko, hello, obvious ba? Wala na akong amahan, akong igsuon, akong inahan. It's as if you're stating the obvious and you are rubbing salt on open wound. Perhaps she was just groping for the right words to say to express sympathy. Pero ang iyang gibuhat, all the more highlighted my reality nga difficult kaayo. I left the grocery without even buying anything. Grabe kaayo ang nasinati ko nga sadness. Gitawag kini sa mga psychologists nga POS. Yes, na a term. POS means pain of separation. It is most intense when someone leaves us and we feel we are left behind and we feel no one cares anymore or we are just taken for granted and so alone in the world. Mauna ang summary sang POS. Kung makakonnect kita sa nao na experience natong kanang POS, kining ebanghelyo is actually a prelude to the ascension of the Lord. And the Lord is giving them a message, preparing them for the time that He will return to the Father, the ascension mystery. But before that, He gives them the answer sa ilang kaguol, kining pain of separation, kining sadness. That is why 3 points I would like to leave for our reflection. Number one, love. Number two, obedience. And number three, the role of the Holy Spirit. The first verse of the gospel, claro kaayo. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. So the Lord is telling His apostles, and by extension, you and me, kung naatay masinati nga pain of separation, then the key is to remain in His love. Very important to remain in His love. Jesus is the vine. We are the branches. Cut the branches and we will not bear fruit. The flow of the nutrients, the flow of fruitfulness can only come from Jesus who loves us. So the invitation is to remain in His love. For me, it's always very interesting that when we feel the pain of separation, we look for someone to attach ourselves, to look for pseudo or passing happiness. We look for false loves. Jesus in the gospel tells His apostles, you and me, during moments of crisis and moments of pain, choose to remain in my love. But here's the thing. Jesus immediately jumps to its correlative statement. If you truly love me, you will keep my commands. Here, St. John, the apostle or the evangelist of love, is not only talking about love as a beautiful affection. He is actually very practical. For him, love is validated. The true test of love is obedience to God's commandments. Yes, you know, dali lang magsulti sa inyong mga spouses, wives or husbands, I love you, darling. Pero if you do not obey the moral demand to be faithful to your spouse, then naigap ang pagigugma. Or you say, I love my family, pero ang imong kwarta naa sa bisyo, sa inom or sa gambling, naay discrepancy. Dili siya tinuod ng pagigugma. Or even ang mga bata, they say, I love and honor my parents. Pero dili sila magtuo when the parents would tell them, go home, anak, dili mag-waste ang imong time o kwarta sa computer nga inuras na. Nakana ba? Or even for us who claim to be Christians and we don't even follow, you know, the church's commandments. And even during this quarantine period, kung naa kita'y palusot ba sa mga quarantine rules, we say we love our country, but we also discriminate one another. And we allow ourselves to be overwhelmed by fear. Brothers and sisters, sa mauning sitwasyon, the second point that the gospel would like to emphasize is to remain in the love of Christ is validated if we keep His commandments. Now here, this is the third point. Here, the reality is to keep the commandments na ay struggle. Yes, kay na ay subconscious. Dili man ta rebelde oy, pero usahay we look at maunang sa catechesis na kin-share ko kanang a while ago in another talk. Na kanaan ay unconscious reaction ba sa commandments kay we feel it's a burden. So na ay aversion. Or usahay wala naton kina deny, pero we negotiate. Palusot ba? Tawag na ito diha sa atong lingwahe. So, in this struggle to stay in love with God and to keep His commandments, the key is we need the help of God. And this is where He comes in with a beautiful expression, I will never leave you orphans. I can really connect to this. Perhaps maybe because katong babae, kitawag niya ko nga orphan ka na, Father, no? So, kidding, the Lord is telling you and me, you will never be alone if you remain in my love and you keep my commandments. And even when you struggle to do that, I will help you. I will send the Spirit. Ang gigamit the word is parakletos. Now to translate it is very hard, parakletos, paraclete in English, but it's better understood, the Holy Spirit, sa iyang role. Ang statement, a pinakaduol na translation according to one exegesis is this, it's someone called in to help. Mauni ang parakletos, someone called in to help. Sa tinuod lang, when do we usually pray to the Holy Spirit? Yes, kung may mga students din ha, ang nagapaminaw karon during exams, right? Especially kung wala takatuon ba, maampo ito sa chapel, tabangin mo ko, Lord, makapasa sa akong test. Pero okay man na, kay na ay someone called in to help you pass your exams. Pero sa atong kinabuhi ba, sa atong journey of life, sa atong struggle, sa atong wrestling with temptations, sa atuhang, you know, working out kining mga issues na to, kining atong struggle with the loneliness and the pain of sadness. In all of this, we are never abandoned by the Lord. We are never taken for granted because Jesus loves us. And His gift is the gift of the Parakletos, the gift of the Holy Spirit. What I like best about someone called in is this. For example, kanando abukatos ba? Advocatus or abogado sa ato ha? Pag dili ka kasulti, kinakuyawan ka. The Spirit comes in if we ask for God's help to help us communicate well. When we are making crucial decisions in life, the Spirit comes in to help us. So someone called to help us. At for me, one of the beautiful ways that the Spirit comes in during these difficult times is the Spirit who comes in to become our comforter. I like the word comforter. Kay gagikan man sa Latin ang fortis, cum fortis. Meaning, the Spirit comes in to provide us and to help us with power. Most often, ang comforter, makita nato na the Spirit comforts us when we are sad. Nindot mana, the Spirit comforts us to give us consolation. Beautiful and true. But we forget ka ang fortis is actually fortitude, strength, power. So during these difficult times, dili naton malikayan ang question, and I have to confess, usahay mag-ampo ko nag-aagi man ni siya, asa man ang Dios in all our sufferings karon? Dagipabayaan man ta ba? Did the Lord leave us? Did the Lord abandon us? Especially during this pandemic. During this situation, the gospel tells us, remain in the love of God. We keep His commandments that are life-giving. And above all, we receive the gift of the Spirit, Comforter. Meaning the Spirit who will provide us with the power to be brave. Interesting, no? The power to be brave. Usahay kung fear lang ang atong isubscribe, we will be paralyzed. Again, I would always say, we will be paralyzed, then ang atong immune system, apektuhan pud. And not only that, we will also look at others with that kindness when we discriminate. And then we will not be guided on what is the proper thing to do, the positive thing to do. To be brave during this time is the gift of the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, the Comforter, Comfortis. The Spirit will come to us when we call upon Him. Someone called in to give us strength, to give us power. When we experience this pain of separation, when we feel we are orphaned, when we feel that the world is taking us for granted, the gospel gives us a source of hope. Jesus tells you and me, I have never cut my love for you. Remain in my love. And what is the best way to remain in my love? Keep my commandments. And yes, it's not easy. You will struggle. But I will send the Holy Spirit to help you. The Spirit Comforter. The Spirit, the Paraclete. The Spirit who will help you be brave during these difficult times. As we conclude, my prayer, my wish, when we encounter these tests and difficulties, may the Spirit come in our lives and give us fortitude, strength, courage. And when we do this, then we know we will find healing and salvation. So help us, God.